Dr. Ansari has more than 18 years of experience in academics, research, and industry. His area of research include digital signal, image processing, feature extraction, biorenewable, solar energy, soft computing, etc. He has supervised 8 doctoral scholars. He has more than 120 research paper publications in reputed international and national journals and conferences. He has chaired many sessions in various international conferences. He has also delivered many keynotes, notes and expert lectures. He has also been reviewer in many journals and conferences like IET Computer Vision UK, InterScience, IEEE, etc. He is a member of many societies, senior member IEEE USA, senior member IET UK, life member IAM India. Sir, it is a pleasure to have you with us. Sir, I request you to please begin your session.
Thank you, Dr. Aarti. I am very thankful to the organizers of this 2 weeks online expert lecture series on research trends in ICT by the Department of Computer Science and Engineering and Electronics and Communication Engineering, School of ICT, Gautam Buddha University, Greater Noida. So, today I'll be delivering a lecture on the evolution of the transforms and soft computing based processing of biomedical signals and medical imaging. As we go through the research trends in today's scenario, we find that the biomedical engineering is one of the most emerging field in medical science or biomedical engineering. Particularly, the applications of the transform techniques and soft computing techniques are playing the key role in the information processing of the biomedical images or the biomedical signal, particularly extracting the features of these signals and images, maybe the feature extraction or the analysis or finding some tumors or finding some case studies like insomnia or the brain seizures or cardiovascular strokes. So such common disease very easily can be identified through the analysis of the biomedical signal and the images, and the tools, particular tools for these analysis or the transform based techniques or the soft computing based techniques. Particularly in this presentation, I will be covering mainly the evolution of the transforms and various transform based codings, wavelet analysis, composition of the wavelets, wavelets in medical imaging, wavelets in signals, and soft computing and typical applications of the wavelets. So let us start with a very introductory part of the an image, because we will be talking mainly on the signal and image processing and application to the soft computing and the wavelet transform. We can see here the two images, and we see that the images are full of noise. Both of the images full of noise. So we need some technique or some methods which can be useful to extract the exact information from an image. This is a medical image. You can see that the first image before the transformation and the second image after the transformation. So through the transformation process, we can change the image or the signal noise, or remove the noise from the signal or image, and we can get up to 99.99% of the exact information from an image. Aarti, am I audible properly? Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yeah. So I want feedback together, please. We have to make the session live. Okay. So everyone is welcome to have any query anytime. So because this will be an interesting session. So this is the one case of the medical image. This is one case of the astrological image you can see taken by the NASA. And you can see the four stages of an image, where the noise from the case B is extracted in part of C. C is the called as the coarse, and D is the called the detailed two images. Now, if you come to the just I'm in the introductory part, I'm giving some example, then we'll be taking one by one properly. So these are the various types of the signals. First one is the cosine, Second one is the Doppler signal, and third one is the mixture of a signal, and fourth one is the fractal signal. So such type of signals, if are having the some noise in this, so we don't have any direct method to remove the abnormality from these signals. But the transform based coding techniques based on the wavelet transform or the discrete wavelet transform or the curvelet or the shearlet transform are very strong tools to get rid of these problems from such signals. The third example I am giving you, that we have an image, how the image is broken into various coefficients from an image. If you go on dividing the image through the wavelet theory, we get the divide by two. And the higher frequency component in such way can be extracted, and we can get the noise removal from the image. So this is the case where after the removal of the noise and the main frequency component. So details or the noise components are called the detail, and the course where you which the main components or the main coefficient from an image which we retain or which we select or call the coarse part. So this way we can very easily remove the noise from an image. The various areas of the transform based coding techniques, as we discussed in the beginning as well, the scientific computations, like in the scientific computations, like removal of the noise from various medical signals or the images, or some scientific predictions like using the soft computing methods, and the feature extraction and the pattern recognition, biometrics, bioinformatics, DNA, microdata analysis, biomedical signal and image analysis, geophysics and astrophysics, meteorological studies, financial engineering. And there are many miscellaneous fields nowadays. Data science or data informatics is there, where we can very easily use the transform-based technique to find out some feasible solutions of the various problems associated with the signals and the images. So, as my topic is the evolution of the transforms and the soft computing, let us see how the transform came into existence and how the transform-based techniques are useful in the processing of the biomedical signals and the images. So all we know that these are the various transforms which are in the current scenario existing. These are the main transforms. Laplace transform, I hope everyone has studied the Laplace transform. Fourier series and Fourier transform, everyone has studied. Fast Fourier transform, discrete Fourier and short time fast Fourier transform, sine and cosine transform, then DCT. And now here the main research work may be taken from the wavelet transform or discrete wavelet transform or the MRA, that is multi-resolution analysis. And then we come up to the wavelet packets. And then the latest one is the shearlet, curvelet, and ridgelet transforms. So anyone have any query regarding the transforms, I can reply here. How many of you have studied any these transforms? Anyone has used any one of these transforms? Hello,
sir.
Anyone have idea of the transforms? These transforms, or have used in their research work, or guided to the students? No idea. Anyway, let us go ahead. First the. The very beginning, we started with the Fourier analysis. We will not be going into detail of the Fourier analysis because it was in the early 19th century it was developed, and we all know that how the Fourier series works. We break the any signal into various components of the sine and cosine waves, and the formula is given. This was developed in during the 1768 to 1830 by Joseph Fourier. So what is the basic problem with the Fourier series? We have the basic problem with the Fourier series that there are different periods is not efficient. Fourier series does not converge. We can see here that as the points where you can see that at the converging points or the sharp points, the Fourier series does not work efficiently. So the so this is not very much useful for the medical imaging. Then it came to the Fourier transform. So in the Fourier transform, what we do, a signal can be converted to from the time domain to frequency domain, as given by the formula. And you can see in the pictorial form how the time amplitude and time signal is converted through Fourier transform to the amplitude and the frequency domain. So the basic problem with the Fourier transform is that a time domain signal is converted to the frequency domain signal, and the problem is that we lost the time information. We don't know at what point or at what sequence of time what is happening. And the other problem with the Fourier transform is that the Fourier transform cannot locate or detect non-stationary or transitory characteristics like drift, trends, abrupt changes, beginning and ends of events of a signal. So these are the main drawbacks of the Fourier. Then after Fourier transform, it came to the short time Fourier. I just very quickly in 5-10 minutes, I will be covering all the introductory transforms. Then we'll be coming to the main Bayesian transform. So in the short Fourier transform, the effort was made that in what was the drawback of the Fourier transform, that we were losing the time information from a signal. So in the short time Fourier transform, an effort was made to have the a window. And along with the frequency component, we must have some time sequence. You can see when we are applying the STFT from on a signal, we are having the main frequency and the time in terms of some window forms. You can see the blocks here. So these are called the windows. And here the window length will be T minus T dash given by the formula. So we see that as the short time and Fourier transform depends upon the side of the window. You can see four examples of the using the short time Fourier transform. First, second. So as we are increasing the window size, the information details are losing. So this one, the fourth one is the smallest window size, and the first one is the longest window size. So in the next one, it will be more clear. You can see here that any signal XT, if we have the window size between 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, and 20 seconds. So in the part where we have the 25 millisecond window size, we have more details as compared to 1000 millisecond window size. So in the short Fourier transform, drawback is that the information retrieval is the window size dependent, and therefore it not solve your purpose probably to analyze a medical signal or any signal or any image in the time or the frequency domain. Here we can have a more clear view of the STFT, that the narrower window you can see in figure A have higher details or more details as compared to the window wide window size. Now, what we do basically the transform based coding. Now we come up to the transform based coding. What is the transform based coding? In the transform based coding or the transform based image processing mainly, we have three components there. First one is the transformation, second is the quantization, and the third is entropy encoding. Along with that, we have the pre-processing, and that is called the filtering. You can see in the block here that the pre-processing, then you apply the transform, then you quantize, and then you encode or the it is called a symbol encoder. You get the bit stream, you can store or transmit, and the reverse process you can retrieve the image. So this is a basic, very basic block diagram of the transform based coding. So first after the STFT, the first transform which come into effect was the DCT, that is the discrete cosine transform, in which we take we divide any pixel of the image into 8x8 pixel blocks, and then we process them. Here you can see the basic formula of the DCT, where we have this is for 2D we can have 1D also. If we have 1D, then only one summation will be enough here. So this is how the discrete cosine transform in implemented. In the previous block where we put the wavelet transform, in place of the wavelet transform, you can put the DCT. And the main drawback of the DCT is that the DCT is implemented into 8x8 block extractor. And when you are recombining them, there is some problem in the image or the signal while you are rejoining. That is called the blocking artifacts. You can see here. The first one is this, 8x8 DCT, and the second one is by wavelet. This will be I'll discussing later. So I let me show in a image form. This is the image which is implemented the DCT. So you can see here, if you apply the 8x8 matrix size, so when we recombine, then the recombined blocks at the joining point have some traces. These are called the blocking artifacts. So this is the main drawback of the DCT. So the DCT also does not solve the purpose. So the wavelet analysis is the solution of all these problems, and wavelet analysis is very strong and very powerful tool to analyze the medical images and the signals or any type of the signals through its multi-resolution analysis property. So what the wavelets are based on with the following properties: short time localized wave with zero interval value, possibility of time shifting. The one of the most important feature of the wavelet transform is that the wavelets have both the features of time and frequency. As we saw in the previous cases in the Fourier transform, fast Fourier transform, DCT, that while we are shifting the signal or image from one domain to other domain, we lose the property of time, that we have the frequency domain information. Whereas in the wavelet transform, at the same time, you can have both the properties of wavelet, that is the time domain and the frequency domain. That is, you can have the time information at the same time as well as the frequency time. And this is very flexible. Any frequency, any magnitude signal can be analyzed through wavelets. So these are some features. This is the some historical background that I will not go through much about that. So this is how wavelet is applied. You can see that in the wavelet, while we are implementing the wavelets, we have the variable size regions. You can see in the wavelet analysis this figure. You can have you see last wavelet analysis time figure. So first one is the any time signal in time domain. This time domain signal is converted to by the wavelet transform into the various scales in the time domain, and in the various scales you will be getting the various frequency components. As you can see, that low frequency as well as high frequency in the window, you can see any frequency signal available in the signal is can be seen here and at various time intervals. Here you can understand in more detailed view of the wavelet signal analysis. So in the time domain, if you come, we come in the base, we get the better frequency resolution and in the base. And if you want the better time resolution, we can take the upper samples. So this way the wavelet analysis can give any time better frequency and a better time resolution signals depending upon your need. If you need higher resolution signals in the frequency domain, then you have to take the base signals. If you want the better time resolution, then you go the upper side. These are the basic four components you see in the first time domain, the amplitude and time. In the second frequency domain, that was the Fourier, you have the frequency, the amplitude. In the third part, you have the STFT, where we have a shorter window, frequency and the time. And in the fourth part, we have the wavelet, where we have the scaling of the signals into various regions where you can find out, and in any region, the frequency and the time, both parameters from a signal. Here an example of that, how the wavelet is superior to other analysis signals like the Fourier transform. This is the signal. First, you can see it. You see the circle here. You see the circle here. And if we analyze this signal through the 4-year coefficients, you cannot find any discontinuity in the 4-year. Can you see it here in the middle figure? So in the middle figure, you will not find any this circle. Yani here is the break or discontinuity in the signal. You cannot find here. But while you are studying this through the wavelet transform, you can very easily are identifying that discontinuity through the wavelet transform. Same signal. While we are analyzing this signal through the Fourier coefficient or the Fourier analysis, we are not finding anywhere the discontinuity. But while we are analyzing this signal, we can very easily find the wavelet discontinuity in the wavelet coefficient. So the wavelet transform is capable of revealing aspects of data that other methods miss, like trends, breakdown points, discontinuity in higher derivative, and self-similarity. And which is the most important part of the medical imaging. If you go through or analyze the medical imaging, you have to have analyzed the trends of the medical imaging for the feature extraction, breakdown points for the segmentation purpose, discontinuity for any texture analysis, and higher derivatives, and self-similarity for the the biometric applications of the medical imaging. So these are the now I will be telling you how the wavelet basic fundamental components of the wavelet analysis. So this is the sine wave and this is the wavelet DB10 here. So how we get this wavelet analysis? So in the wavelet analysis, we have the mother wavelets, scaling, and the translation. There are mainly three components. The basic wavelet is nothing but a small wave. Then it is the mother wavelet. Then we have the scaling. And then we have the translation. So all these parts I will be discussing. So this is the basic mother wavelet, the equation, and you can see the formula down. You see, this is the basic fundamental formula of the mother wavelet. Here there are two components, A and B. So is anyone aware of this wavelet theory? So, okay, little bit good, then we can go in detail. So you can see the mother, there are some mathematical things, please, if not clear, you are welcome to ask. But this is very strong research tools nowadays, you can use it. So in the mother wavelet, you can see two basic components. Here, xi is known as the mother wavelet function. Like we write xt or yt, similarly we write xi t here. Where A is called the scaling of the parameter and B is called the shifting. Here in the mother wavelet, you can see the width of the signal and the magnitude of the signal. So if you want to scale it, like we can have the contract or expand the wavelet, then we need the scaling. Okay, so we have to change A here. And if we want to shifting in time domain like x minus t, x minus 2t, x minus 3t, then we have to change the B. So that is called the shifting. So these are the basic three properties of the wavelets. First is the admissibility condition. This is the, if a wavelet fulfill this condition, then if any function will fulfill this condition, then only it will come under the wavelet category. B is the finite energy. The wavelet must have the finite energy. And third one is the unity energy from minus infinity to plus infinity under these conditions. These are the various wavelet families. There are more than 20 wavelet families, and the most useful. Then we have the DB series, that is called the Dervish wavelet, Simulet, Copeland, Biorthogonal, Near. So many Gaussian. There are so many wavelet series, wavelet families. We use them, and these are their family functions. You can see them. They all have, even you can make your wavelet family, wavelet function if you want. I will tell you how to do that. This is wavelet in multiple dimensions. You can see that. This is a Mexican hat, fourth derivative of Gaussian wavelet. This is in n dimension if you want to have a wavelet. Now the let us come the application of the wavelet, how the wavelets are useful in signal processing. This is the first figure, see original signal, and if you want to compress this signal, you can see here very easily. So level 1, level 2, level 3, and level 4. So level 1 will be the lowest frequency components, and we have this as the compressed signal. And the details, level 2, level 3, and level 4 are called the details or the noise part from the signal, and then they can be extracted. This similarly, the second case here also. So you can discard the details and you can have the level 1 coefficients. So this way you can, and even if you want to compress at any level, like it is divided by 3, it means that coefficients, if I divide by 3, like just like in quantization, all communication people are here. What we do in the quantization, we fix the quantization value. So quantization value may be increased or decreased or any level we want. Similarly here, the coefficients may be divided by any value we want the compression of the signal. If suppose we want the 10 times compression of a given signal, then divide the coefficient by 10, whatever the coefficients you have selected. So this way we can compress the signal. Now this is the second example, is the denoising of the signal or the image. You can see here how we denoise it. Then this is the data compression we have already told. I will telling how we get it in the like detecting discontinuity and breakdown points, detecting long-term evolution, detecting self-similarity, identifying pure frequencies, suppressing signals, denoising signals or filtering, and the compressing signals. There are many other applications also that I have not mentioned all of them. There are hundreds of applications of the wavelet. So now we have in the wavelet, we have two types of wavelet. One is the continuous. Similarly, in the communication system, we have the digital communication and we have the analog communication. So similarly here, we have the continuous wavelet transform and we have the discrete wavelet transform. The continuous wavelet transform, similarly the Fourier transform formula you can see here. So this is the Fourier analysis. We have the sinusoidal components when we break a signal through Fourier analysis. But when we break the signal through the wavelet transforms, we have two main positions, that is the scale and position. So here we can see that as in the previous example, we have A and B. Here the same is replaced by tau and S. Tau is the translation and S is the scale. XT is the main fundamental signal which you want to implement the wavelet transform, and xi star t minus tau upon s, that is the mother wavelet which you can have the har or bi-orthogonal or shear any mother wavelet you can apply here in the main formula. And this is the how the breaking of the signal takes place while implementing the wavelet. You can see here this is the main signal, and while you implement the wavelet transform, the different frequency component, that is called the multi-resolution. The signal is decomposed of the various constituents of the wavelets having different scales and positions. You can see every signal have, and that is why any energy signal or any frequency signal can be composed of through the wavelet decomposition, because it consists of the variety of the signals having high frequency, low frequency, high translation and low translation. So all the frequency components, that is why the wavelet is all of you must have seen the LINA image in the image processing. Many times use LINA image. That is the reason behind that the LINA image having the most of the frequency components in associated with it. So that is mostly used in the research. So this is the continuous wavelet, how we implement it. So here one thing I would like to tell you, that what is the meaning of the scaling and the translation. So let us say A is the scaling. So you can see here, if we want to have the low scale, that is for low scale, that is the compressed wavelet. So it will be rapidly changing. So first signal, you can see down one, that is the low scale signal, that is A will be low, that is the compressed signal. In the B part, you can have high scale, that is A will be high, that is the signal is stressed. So the same signal, applying the wavelet, mother wavelet, you can stretch or you can make it high scale depending upon your requirement. So now that what we do in the discrete wavelet transform, how we apply the discrete transform, the communication electrical. So if you want to have any signal from the continuous domain to the discrete domain, the integral part is converted to the summation part. So same signal in the first equation, it is the continuous Fourier transform. Now, if you want to convert it into discrete Fourier transform, simply the integral part is converted to the summation part, and Mn, and it is for 2D. Here also we have the scaling and the translation. And here the scaling 1, 2, 3. In the continuous, we have the direct 0 to t. And here we have 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever we want represented by n. And this is the discrete Fourier transform implementation part, how we divide the approximations and details. We implement the discrete Fourier transform on a signal through this. So high frequency and low frequency components are divided. So the high frequency components are denoted by CD and low frequency components are denoted by CA. And in other words, you can represent this as the low pass filter and the high pass filter. In the low pass filter, we stop the low frequency components and pass the high frequency. And high pass filter, we high pass the high frequency components and stop the low frequency components. So similarly here in the DWT. So you can see the when the signal is totally decomposed, so S is the original signal. So these are the various components of the signal. So D1, D2, D3 are the details, and A3 is the approximation signal. So this detailing of the signal is called the analysis, and when you are recombining the signal, that is called the synthesis. So here you can see that how the when the DWT is implemented on a signal, that you make the details of the various frequency components, so and you obtain the Fourier coefficients. So the reverse process, that is the inverse DWT, can recombine the signals, and in this process you can discard the components which you don't need. Here is another example how you make the scaling and detailing. This is an example of a signal, that how the signal is filtered, and high frequency details, the CD1, CD2 are the details, CA1, CA2, CA3 are the approximation. That is the signal part which you want or which you take up, and details are the noise parts which you will discard. This is the other example. Have anyone gone through this type of window in the MATLAB toolbox? Hello. मैं जल्दी चल रहा हूँ क्या? Fast हूँ? Am I fast? हाँ. Okay, thank you. So okay, because this is a 2-hour lecture and you have given me this, I have given a keynote. So because even if I want to, if I start explaining only one wavelet, it will take 30 minutes. So anyway, this you can find out. Let me tell you that you go to the wavelet toolbox, MATLAB toolbox, and type the wave menu, and you will get a wavelet. Wavelet toolbox there, and you can find out. Let us say, for example, we have one signal, and we have applied. You can see the in the middle dB wavelet. You see the applied wavelet is dB4, okay, and up to level 5. We want to decompose it up to level 5, okay. So if up to level 5, where you can see D1, D2, D3, D4, and D5. This is called up to level 5. So we can decompose the signal, and we can approximate and leave the details. Details are not much useful matching frequency component to the original signal, maybe noise also. So you can discard that. So this is one of the example how you can filter out a signal easily. Then how we implement the 2D computer 2D of an image, alter the transform coefficient and compute the inverse transform. This will be, I will be telling one an image. This was the example of the signal. This figure I have also told you in the beginning, that this is the step of the transformation, how the wavelet is implemented. simply apply the wavelet transform, forward wavelet transform, quantize the signal, and then encode the coefficients. Then the stream of the coefficient, whether you may store it or you transmit it. If you want to transmit, then you have to apply the inverse process so that you can retrieve the signal or the image. This is the figure how the frequency components are transmitted after the decomposition part. So here I would like to tell you that iske aage ek aur acha example hai jo aapko bahut acha lagega. So LL are the low frequency components. This is called the level 1. So first we go to the horizontal 1D DWT applied alternatively to vertical and horizontal directions line by line. The LL band is recursively decomposed first vertically and then horizontally. This is called the Mallet method of decomposition. So the LL frequency components are the most useful, are the low frequency component, and the rest are the higher frequency component. They are discarded in the system. This is, you can see the example I am giving you, how the, you can see it here. First we have the image here. So first we have, you see, this is the divide by 2, okay, down sampling. This is called the down sampling, H0 and H1. So you have to break it by HS. So you get the H0 and H1. The image part is H0 and H1 is the higher frequency components. You again divide by 2. So this is the level 1 decomposition. So the part where the image is there, you will be getting A0, that is LL. And the remaining will be A01, A10, and A11, downsampled frequency. They frequency components may be discarded, and you can get it. So I now, this the actual example of the medical image, how you can see the original ultrasound image. Here I have applied three level. Can you see the wavelet applied here? Which wavelet is applied here?
Yes, sir.
It is bi-orthogonal. You see right side box top corner. Right side.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Yeah, you see the wavelet, it is bi-orthogonal wavelet, okay, 6.8 and level 3. So you can have any, you can have the statistics of the wavelet or compress it or denoise it, or you want to histogram, see it, histogram of it. So here we have just filtered out the image up to level 3. So here by yellow color, this is called the DWT. You apply the DWT. Here the image selection, here any place you select, you will get the image part, and it is IDWT. This is the inverse wavelet transform, you get the image. And if you more extracted, you can find out in this form. So you can identify which part from the previous figure is here taken. You can see here, first one is the original image and the first LL part. I have shown here, see, very small letter, it is written here, LL at the top. Okay, then LH, then HH, then HL. Okay, so here, finally here, in figure, this one, E, compressed image, this one is the compressed image. This is the histogram part of the image. And this is the difference from the original image and the compressed image. So different, this is the noise part of the image. This is the decomposition of the denoising. Here you can see the in various L1, L2, L3. These are the histograms of the details of the image. And this is one of the example I have shown here. This is maybe not of much interest, but those who are working doing research on this, this is very much useful. Even from this table, one paper can be published. So these are the some comparative images of the various wavelet and DWT, various methods. You can see, then we have other applications of the wavelets. You can see that. Now, if you want the segmentation of the, this is the, hope everybody know, this is the segmented image implementing the wavelet transform. So you take the MRI or the CT scan, you can easily find the boundaries. So I told you in the beginning that if you want to find out the sharp boundaries in an image or the signal, so the wavelet tool will be one of the strongest method, one of the best tool to find out very easily. While the Fourier transform or the fast Fourier transform or the discrete Fourier transform methods are not much useful of finding the sharp band read. And this way we can segment an image to find out the texture of an image or the abnormality of an image. Here the second example of the segmentation. Now even 3D imaging can be taken care of by the wavelets. You can see the example here. Now now the some of the biomedical signals analysis by the wavelets, signal like blood flow, blood pressure, cardiac output, electrocardiography, electroencephalography, all these signal EEG, ECG, EMG, or all their ranges are given here. So few example like ECG and EMG I have taken. So this is the ECG here. First figure you can see, here are the RR interval. These are the various intervals of this. And here, if you analyze such type of the signal, these are the examples and analysis in the next TP. So you can find out by applying by various wavelets. Like this is the EEG signal, first one. And you see that DB5 is implemented here. And in this DB6 is implemented here. And the last one is the coflet 01 and this one is the coflet 02. So you can implement the wavelets on any type of the signal and you can analyze the property or the feature of an of the signal. This is in the wavelet toolbar so that you should know how it we are achieving it. You just implement the signal. This you can get in the wavelet toolbox. This is denoising. This is detecting these continuities. कोई क्वेरी हो तो बताते जाइए आप लोग कुछ पूछ तो नहीं बिल्कुल कोई पूछ तो रहा नहीं कोई अच्छा ओके एक्चुअली मुझे जो है ना इट इज अ प्रॉब्लम दैट आई एम नॉट एबल टू सी हाउ मेनी वो जो है कितने पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं वो नहीं पता चल रहा है क्योंकि मैं पूरा विंडो मेरे सामने आ रहा मैं चाह रहा था कि इसमें जो है वो मेरा साइड विंडो आ रहा कितने अच्छा 40 गूगल मीट पे हैं अभी देखता हूँ अच्छा ठीक है तो अभी तक किसी की कोई क्वेरी हो तो बताइए फिर मैं आगे बढ़ूँ हाँ यू हैव यस सो दिस वे यू कैन डिटेक्ट द डिसकंटिन्यूटी बाय इंप्लीमेंटिंग द DB5 Here you can see that where there is discontinuity in the signal, you can very easily find here that the signal gives the discontinuity at the point. Now detecting the self similarity, particularly if you want to analyze the biometric of an of a person or of an image, so you can dissimilarity. Here is the dissimilarity in the signal, and you can find it out here. And here we have applied the coflet 3. And sample period 1, so you can find it out here. Some of the typical applications are of the signal processing, maybe application of wavelet to class of medical signals. First type of EEG signals. Let us see this one. One of the EEG example. This was simulated by one of the research scholars. That you can simulate or analyze the scalogram showing time, frequency, and amplitude of EEG signal. Or even you can analyze the epileptic signals, or you can analyze the cardiac stroke signals through this wavelet analysis. Yes. What? Sorry, can you please repeat the question? No, for which type of signal analysis you want this thing? No, which type? No. What is the objective of this? Which type of the signal or image you want to analyze for this? You want to check the self similarity? You want to check the self similarity? So for self similarity, you can have DBA. This biorthogonal is very efficient for that. I shown you the example for self similarity check. This one, you can have the coflet here or biorthogonal. You can check through this self similarity. Through this. Or even one of my research scholar has done the PhD just Viva in next week. He has done the biometric analysis. He has done all the self-similarity check of various biometric images through applying these wavelets. You got the reply of your question or not? Or if you want to more advanced, then you can go to the shearlet transform. The latest one has come to the curvelet and shearlet transform, where in the curvelet transform basically on the similar principle that is 360 degree, like in the CT image, what we do that we take the 360 degree rotation of an ultrasound. So in the curvelet and shearlet transform, what we do, we have the sharp edge findings. So the shear lead can be one level better option for this also. You can try for that. I can give the toolbox of shear lead also, that is with me. No problem. Okay, so this one is the application of the analysis, and this is the, they have some comparative results. So now we can conclude that the wavelet applications not only restricted to biomedical images, they are very much relevant to the physics, particularly in astronomy or geophysics. Then in telecommunication engineering, like signal processing, sub-band coding, speech recognition, and then mechanical engineering, turbulence analysis, medical digital radiology, computer aided diagnosis, human vision perception, and applied and pure mathematics, fractals. Yes, that I wanted to tell you that as per your question, in the fractals analysis, what we do, we do analysis on the basis of some slopes, some lines in fractals analysis. So similarly, in the curvelet transform, shearlet transform, you can have more sharp edges as compared to the wavelets. Then we have the pattern recognition. In the pattern recognition, we have the to distinguish the normal from the normality from the pathological membranes, biometrics, feature extraction, then trend detection, then finance, perfect reconstruction, communication, wireless channel signals. JPG 2000. Do you know that your all the images in WhatsApp or video compression, what is the theory behind that? Can anybody reply? What is JPG 2000? All the images you play within your WhatsApp or that JP, you see the extension of the image, it is either JPG or JPG 2K. So this is JPG 2000. So the background, the wavelet theory is there. Background is JPG 2000 video coding. Then we can have the future video or the image compression, improved low bitrate compression performance, improved lossless and lossy compression. Because in medical imaging, we are not much allowed to have the lossy compression. We have to have limited compression ratio. So the lossless compression may be preferred. The improved continuous tone and bit level bi-level compression, be able to compress large images, use single decompression techniques, transmission in noise environments, robustness, progressive transmission, protective image security. Image security also one of the important feature of the wavelet applications. So these are some of the software links you can find out if you want. MATLAB wavelet toolbox, those who want to work on wavelet, they can discuss anytime to me. These are the three links I have provided. You can find out The first one, wavelet mathworks.com, wavelet toolbox. From there, you can find out the rest other wavelet menus are there. Or if you want to go the wavelet itself, wavelet site, wavelet.org, you can find out these links to work upon. These are some references. This is those who are the outsiders, they can see the beauty of our GPU. This is our beautiful GPU. We are here. These are our some students, some activities, School of ICT, School of Engineering, beautiful infrastructure. Thank you. Demerits of the wavelet transform is that if we compare to the DCT, I shown you in the early, that DCT little bit time consuming. If you implement a DCT and DWT on a single image together, so the computational time may be little bit shorter of DCT as compared to, because DWT decomposes the image into n number of constituents. So while the recombining all this, so little bit more, not much, but slightly higher time as compared to DCT. So that is only one drawback of the wavelet. Otherwise, wavelet have all the merits. I have done my all research work, everything. I am associated with wavelet long time. So I have been associated in one book, also Professor Abul Hasan Siddiqui, sir. So he was my mentor, though unfortunately he's no more. But he had written several books on the wavelets. So wavelet is a very strong tool of research. Anyone can go through it. Yeah, I can write here on. Okay, I create my email ID. Anyone want to? I just write here, don't worry, email. Anyone who wish to have any query through email, you can put here. Thank you, madam.
Thank
for
you
providing
a very nice session.
Though I was not. Thank you so much for providing such a good opportunity. And we can organize such events in our campus. Our service is not necessary that all the time we have outsiders. The insiders can also help you. So this
definitely
is my idea. All the participants, thank you for joining us, and you can work upon this. This is a good tool. And
thank you, Dr. Ansari. It was a very, very nice session. Thank you so much.
Surprised to know that implementing the deep learning algorithm part of or the supervised or unsupervised learning part of the soft computing methods or neural network methods, you can implement through wavelet. This is the beauty of the wavelet. And you can make a hybrid algorithm of the wavelet along with the deep learning or the supervised or the unsupervised or the recurrent. Because from last 4 or 5 semesters, I'm teaching soft computing here in SOE. So many students have done the dissertation part this way also. So in the next part, if you give me a chance, I will be completely covering the soft computing techniques.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, Aarti ma'am. Thank you, Vidushi ma'am. Thank you, Neeta ji. Thank you, Misra sir. Thank you, Bagel sir. All ICT, Pradeep ji, all ICT, Computer Science, EC, Gautam Buddha University. Thank you to Honorable Vice Chancellor sir for permitting us for such activities. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. It was such an informative session, and I hope it would be beneficial for many researchers in this area of wavelet transform. And thank you very much for this session, sir.
Thank you.
Shall we end the call?
Yeah, yes, sure.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Good day, sir.
Thank you very much.